Welcome to Unlock Layouts. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss how to update the DNW diode extractions details in the schematic. So how to clear the LVS. Before starting this video, so this is the continuation video from the part 1 and part 2. If you missed the part 1 and part 2 video, kindly watch those videos so that easily you can understand this part 3. Let's start the video. I have given my personal LinkedIn account here. If you want to connect and follow me, kindly do that. So in our previous part 1 and part 2 video, we have discussed how to add DNW catering manually and how to, the tool is extracting the DNW diode related things in the LVS window. And then now the final work, what we need to do, we need to update the corresponding extracted DNW diode informations into the schematic so that the LVS report we will clear. Okay, so we can easily clear the LVS report. So in order to add the extracted DNW diode from the layout to schematic, first of all, we need to look out our LVS report. Okay, so if I open the LVS report, the extracted LVS report, see in this LVS report, you can clearly see in this bottom line here, there is a diode D2, so there is a diode D0 and D1. Okay, so what kind of diode is that here? So maybe here, the portion where I am highlighting, if you are looking into this portion, see here there is a diode D0 which is connected to between the VSS substrate to VDD. Okay, the formation between VSS substrate to VDD. And what kind of diode is that? It's a P-well DNW diode. Then again there is another diode, that is D1 diode. The diode formation is happening between the VSS RF and VDD. And what kind of diode is that? This diode is also P-well DNW diode. So now we know what kind of diode is that and which area it is forming and what is the diode name. Diode name we can ignore because automatically the tool will take the own call to assign the net name and the name for the diode. But we wanted to add the particular diode, what kind of diode the layout is having, the same kind of diode we need to add in our schematic as well. So just know this name, just see this name, P-well DNW. Okay, so then go to your schematic. Okay, in your schematic, go to insert option, that is nothing but I. Yeah, the schematic is not editable. We have to make your schematic into editable mode. And before that, we have in, if you are working in the real-time project, we are not allowed to do any edit in the schematic until unless if you are not authorized to edit. Okay, so this option we have to discuss with your designer, then do all the edit in your schematic. Okay, so now I am going to add an instance here. Okay, press I, then you'll get an add instance option, then click browse option, go to your PDK library here. Okay, so in this library, just select the category. Here you will see something called diode. Yeah, see here. So in this diode, what type of diode is that? That's a PDNW diode. Okay, just PWDNW. Okay, just type it here, PWDNW. Okay, see if you select PWDNW, see there is a diode is available in your diode section. Go to your library manager, select a diode option. Okay, the category is diode. And what type of diode is that? It's a P-well DNW diode. Okay, select this symbol. Okay, nothing we have to do it here. Just keep the diode in your layout. That's all. Okay, sorry, in your schematic. Then again, we need another diode because both the diodes are same kind of diode. It's not a different type of diode, right? So now I just place two different diodes here. See here, both the diodes are P-well DNW diode here. You can clearly see this statement here. No, the extraction report of caliber. See P-well DNW diode, both the diodes are same diode. Now how to assign the pin name here. That is even more easier because here the diagram is states that which potential is connected to which power. See, we have a D0 diode. One terminal is connected to VSS substrate. Another potential is connected to VDD. We have a D1 diode. One potential is connected to VSS RF. Another potential is connected to VDD. So just see this diagram. And then according to the same diagram, you can connect the connections in your schematic. That's all. The work is very easy actually. So just see this diagram of this diode. If not, I'll extract. I'll keep it in the separate window. See, there I detached that window here. So now if I make fit into this, see, there is a diode. We have a same kind of diode here, PVL DNW diode. Okay, so you can take any diode. Okay, D0, D1, we can consider as any diode. So what exactly doing here? One terminal is connected to VDD. So which potential? Cathode. A common cathode is connected to VDD. Take a wire. Okay, select your window. Take a wire and connect these two potential into common net. Okay, now again, take another wire. Just try to extend the net from here to here because we need to assign another potential here. Yeah, diode is here. So now one potential is connected to VDD. Which potential? That is nothing but our cathode potential. Go to pin name. Type a pin name called VDD. Let it be an input signal. That doesn't matter. Okay, so no need to change anything here. Just assign a pin here called VDD. Then again, just extract this into here, then the same pin name you can assign it to the cathode of that potential. Okay, VDD. Let it be hide. Then again, assign the VDD here. Yeah, one power we have assigned. Then check and save. Yeah, now there is a forewarning. Yeah, this forewarnings, it's easy to clear. Okay, so now D0, one potential is connected to VDD. Where another potential is connected? That is connected to VSS RF, right? So go to the pin name addition here. Okay, go to the create wire name. Then VSS RF, type the VSS RF pin name and assign the VSS RF here. Yeah, one work is completed. Then another diode D1, the potential of D1 is connected to where? Sorry, another diode is D0. D0, another potential is connected to where? VSS substrate. Really, it doesn't matter what diode you are selecting and what type of pin name you are connecting. VSS SUB. Okay, because see, I am doing a wrong connection here. Wrong connection in the sense, instead of D0, I am connecting D1. Instead of D1, I am connecting D0. Okay, the another potential, anode potential. But anyway, the tool will automatically consider that. Okay, now here, VSS substrate. Okay, I'll check and save. See, I have no errors here. I have selected the diode from the library. What type of diode? PVL, DNW, PVL, DNW diode. So how I selected this PVL, DNW diode? Because I got the extraction report from the caliber. The tool is telling that what type of diode inside the layout it is forming. So I just look out the information from the LSW window. I did the same in the caliber. By using the caliber window, I did the same in the schematic. Okay, now again, I'll give the LVS report and let me see how the final LVS report is working. Okay, so finally, now we got our final LVS report. See here, now the instance report, port, everything is clean, but still we have only one error. That is maybe that will be a property error. Yeah, of course. See here, at the final stage, there is no net error, there is no instance error, there is no port error, everything is clean. But the problem is, we have a diode in the schematic which is having some property. We have a diode in the layout which is having a different property. See here, in the diode it is 100 square micron, but in our layout it is 9.608 square micron. Only the property of diode is different here. So yeah, these errors also easily can be resolvable. So what we have to do here, now we need to update those informations in the schematic actually. Go to the schematic editor. Now select what diode is that. See, now here select one diode. Both the diodes are having same kind of property. Okay, D0 and D1. Okay, just select the D0 diode and go to the property of the diode so that here you will see what property is here. Okay, so here diode area is 1 into e to the power of minus 10. Okay, now what we need to do here, instead of 1 e to the power of minus 9, we have to change the exact value which is present here. So here in this window,
we need to update the correct parameter which is present in the layout, the same value we have to update in the schematic. If you update this value, then we can easily clear the diode parameter errors also.
I hope I have given some valuable information to you in this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends. For more details about this video, please contact us to my email ID and follow us on my Facebook page and Twitter page, and kindly subscribe our channel and don't forget to click the bell button.